and best bark at the Stars Fall Festival, the Stratford Animal Rescue Festival. Come on! I can't do it! I can't believe it! He did better, but he had callbacks, you know. He had two auditions.
He's got lipstick on him now. He got a nice groom, and now he's got lipstick. Seriously, I really was very surprised when the interest came from such a distinguished group as yourselves that concerned themselves with only purebred dogs. I think it's a wonderful step in the right direction that we have a dialogue and can educate each other about our perspectives and individual values. I was talking about this subject with your Vice President Gail the other day. I said to her, you know, too many times rescuers are anti-breeding and breeders look down on rescues. I think there's a certain natural animosity that is cultivated there. I've only been doing rescue since this summer, and it is something quite new to me. I must say, as a relative outsider, I can see that many of us seem really crazy. Yeah, I see this. But it's the work itself and what we have to endure day by day just to get our jobs and rescue done is what breeds that extremism. There are things that I've seen since beginning this journey that I never knew existed. The unbelievable cruelty of human beings to animals, the uncaring lack of consciousness and selfishness that's practiced by people who own pets is inconceivable to me. Just this past Thursday, I got an email from Nikki, who does our Blind Deaf Shelter Dogs blog. It was a posting with a picture attached. A cute red and cream palm was sitting on a silver table, and the posting read, "My name is Aries, and I'm described as a male cream 10-year-old Pomeranian Terrier mix." It then read, "Brought in by owner to be euthanized, who said he was too old. Bilateral cataracts, blind, overweight." I quickly got my comm contacts together as the heading said, PTS date ASAP, put to sleep date as soon as possible. I heard on Saturday morning from a colleague at a rescue in California close to where Aries is that they're going to try and pull him. I haven't heard from her since, by the way. I was relieved, but I know that there are already 10 or 20 or 30 more that have already taken his place. Many shelters don't give the special needs dogs a chance to be looked at. They're put in the back room where prospective adopters never see them. And they're euthanized without ever having been given a second chance. I wrote my friend Linda in our incredible intake team not long ago. I was having trouble dealing with the brutal realities of rescue. I didn't know if my getting involved directly was a good idea. Calling rescues, trying to find places for these dogs. Maybe I should just keep my mouth shut and stick to my task and post them. She said to me, these dogs have no voice. They have no one to speak up for them. So if you don't get involved, most of them will die. There's a saying, in rescuing dogs, I lost my mind, but found my soul. And so there it is. This is why I am so grateful to have this opportunity to talk to you. It is by us working together to see the value in each of our perspectives and finding that common ground that will make the difference in changing laws and raising the standards everywhere in this country, which will hopefully lead to more responsible breeding and more responsible dog ownership. I applaud you for your interest, acceptance, curiosity, and progressive open-minded thinking, and I'm so happy that you have welcomed me here to talk about a caring, passionate, and compassionate group of volunteers known as the Blind Dog Rescue Alliance. The next 3 minutes will be the most important 3.5 minutes of this entire talk. These sweet and innocent faces can tell you far more than I'm going to tell you in the next half hour. Without further ado then, let me begin by letting some of the 200 plus dogs of the Blind Dog Rescue Alliance speak for themselves.
When I look in your eyes, I see
One May afternoon last year, I was innocently surfing Pomeranians on the internet. I honestly wasn't looking for a dog. I had just lost my little boy, Frankie. He was 15. He was my very first dog, and although I've had dogs come and go in my life that were equally special, my Frankie was my first dog, my heart dog. So I was terribly despondent and sad, and honestly just wanted to look at beautiful little pictures of Pomeranians on the internet. I saw lots of lovely dogs on breeders' lists, pet finder, all over. And while I admire them, I love all Poms, mixed breed or no, no one really moved me. I wasn't really looking anyway, right? Then I stopped on one and I said, wow, he could be my dog. There was just something about him, some kind of confidence I seemed to see in his face coming from his eyes. His head held high and the wind was blowing his fur. It said his name was Virgil, and that he was being fostered in Wisconsin with a group called the Blind Dog Rescue Alliance. Still not putting together what all that meant. I had never gotten a dog from a rescue. I clicked on him to read more and see bigger pictures. I was then stunned. I was in love with a blind dog. So many things went around in my head at this point. You're not looking for a dog, you know nothing about blind dogs, they're going to be so much trouble. Think how much cheaper it will be. You only have one dog now, that's a lot cheaper. Somebody stares in your house, you'll be carrying him up and down the stairs. How will you know that he needs to go outside? You have stairs to go up and down inside the house, etc., etc. Well, when I got through thinking of ridiculous excuses, I emailed his link to my husband at work with the question, what do you think of this little guy? His answer back was, nice, he's mighty pretty. Not one word about him being blind. After I received that answer, I clicked on apply to adopt. My head was filled with guilt because my Frankie had not even been gone a month. I filled in every single line, including the names and the telephone numbers of three people for personal references. I wasn't really looking for a dog. After I finished the application, I saved his picture and uploaded it to my smartphone. Ruh-roh, I was in trouble. I got off the computer and I called my best friend that I've known all my life who lives in New York City with his little poodle, Tosca. I told him that I had emailed him a link and given his name as a reference. I told him that they might call him, so please let me know if and when they did. He asked about Virgil and I told him everything. There was silence. He then said, "Can I ask you a question?" Silence again. And then he said, "Why do you want to adopt a blind dog?" Without thinking, I said, "I don't want to adopt a blind dog. I want to adopt Virgil." It seems that Blind Dog Rescue Alliance was founded in much the same way that it was, that I found Blind Dog Rescue Alliance in much the same way that it was conceived in the first place, to some large degree by the internet. Karen Melfi, our president and one of the original founders, is based in Philadelphia. She's a registered nurse, working full-time and going to graduate school, and still managing to work full-time hours for Blind Dog Rescue. Karen recounts how it all began in 1999. She had, as she put it, an insane Siberian husky who needed a wrestling partner, so she went on Petfinder to find him a buddy. This is where she saw Ray Charles. That's right, Ray Charles. They're all named Ray Charles, Helen Keller, or Ray, or Charles, or Helen, or just plain Keller. Ray Charles was a nearly two-year-old husky collie shepherd mix who was blind from birth. Karen said she'd never thought of blind dogs before, but she knew she had to adopt him. To prepare, she joined an online support group for blind dog owners to research living with him to see if she felt she could handle it. The group is still in existence, and it's www.blinddogs@yahoo.com. There she found out that blind dogs really aren't much different than sighted dogs. Ray came home with her and her husband Eric on his second birthday, and he was with them until they lost him 10 years later on December 30th, 2009 to cancer. The spring of that same year in 2009, several of the members of the Blind Dogs Yahoo e-group were talking about the number of blind and visually impaired dogs in shelters and the need for a blind dog rescue. Could we do that, she wondered. So they started kicking around ideas, finding prospective members, and the ball started rolling. August the 12th, 2009, they sent in their official Pennsylvania articles of incorporation and arranged to pull their very first foster, Adam. They were official. Adam was fostered, by the way, by Sherry Messino, who fostered my Virgil.